So far, we've discussed the main ideas and assumptions that underlie any instrumental variables analysis. Now, but once you've picked an instrument and argued that all of the assumptions hold, you've got to actually pick a statistical method to implement the instrumental variables strategy. Now, unlike when we analyze natural experiments or regular randomized experiments, we can't just do a simple mean comparison. There are a ton of different methods that you can instead use to implement instrumental variables. I'll start with one that's not so commonly used today, but has all of the main ideas with how instrumental variables works. It's called indirect inference. Now remember the main idea. The main idea is that we look at the correlation between the instrument and the outcome variable. And that correlation tells us something about the causal effect of the treatment on the outcome variable. So here's how indirect inference gets at that treatment effect. There are three steps. The first step is to look at that correlation between the outcome and the instrument. How do we get that? We do a regression. We do a regression of the outcome variable on the instrument. That regression is often called a reduced form regression. Second step, we look at the correlation between the instrument and the treatment. How do we do that? We just do another regression. We regress the treatment on the instrument. And that's often called the first stage effect. So the final step is that we're going to use that first stage effect to adjust the correlation we found from the reduced form regression to get at the causal effect of the treatment on the outcome variable. And that's called the indirect inference estimator. So the main point here is that in the first step, when we got the correlation between the instrument and the outcome, that correlation isn't quite exactly the true causal effect that we're looking for. Instead, it reflects the sum of two different causal effects: the effect of treatment on outcomes, what we want, and the intermediate causal effect of the instrument on the treatment. So we have to adjust out that intermediate effect in order to get the causal effect of treatments on the outcomes. Now, the first stage is what that intermediate effect is. The first stage tells us the causal effect of the instrument on treatment. So we take that first stage and we wipe it out from our correlation of between the instrument and the outcome. That's exactly what indirect inference does.